What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I have some amazing news. Virginia and I are officially signed up for Miles of Mayhem. If you don't know what Miles of Mayhem is, it's like for the west coast of Canada, and it's kind of like the Canadian drag. I don't know why it's Miles of Mayhem, because we measure things in kilometers, but I'm not one to judge. And now that's like a little more than 2 months away, and the goal is to be able to take this car and this car. So we got a lot of bussing to do to get these things ready.
Which means today I'm going to attack some of the
that squirrel. I bet he's on this fence over here. Yeah, I knew it. He's back there.
So I'm going to attack some of the boring stuff on this car, the stuff that isn't really good for filming, like the exhaust, the rear end in this thing, and some stuff in the back, and just get it up and out of the way. That way we can start attacking and putting the new stuff in. And we left this area of the garage like this with the 8 turbos on the floor because they're obviously coming off. And that's off, and all that stuff off. And my single turbo kit is here.
And we're just waiting for my own company, True North Turbos, to be done with the turbo. And what I mean by that is Nick's the mastermind behind all this stuff, and he's gonna get it done.
Virginia's actually out of town today getting a tattoo, so it's up to me to do all this by myself. Okay, now that we're under here, you can see that we've got to get rid of this tank because we have to kind of sump it for our external pumps. We have to get rid of the exhaust on the side here. We also have to get rid of the rear end and the torque box.
We do got a lot of junk in the trunk we got to take out.
Oh no!
I actually want to go cut the exhaust out. We have two of these Sawzalls. One of them works and one of them you kind of need to smash off the floor to like get the motor to free up, but it's not. See? Poor thing. I gotta go to the other garage and get the other one.
Sad.
Oh yeah, Gina also pulled a sneaky and took the Hellcat and left me the truck.
That's okay, it's gonna rain out anyways. I'm friggin' a Toto-so. I'm a weatherman. If it ain't snow, it's rain. It's like May. We haven't had a good day yet. Canada.
Time for the secret passcode. Vagina.
Huh. That's weird. But then again, I've never been good at getting in vagina.
Oh, it was penis. We're storing the frame up here for now. The all-wheel drive parts for the Civic.
Which makes me wish I had a bigger garage I could fit like 4 or 5 cars in because I could be doing this project on the side as well and just have like 3 rotating projects at one time, except it's stuck here.
And the Beetle, which is coming out soon too.
But this is what I need.
I also have this here that I'm probably never gonna use, and this is probably the closest I'm ever gonna get to a carburetor, Dan, at DD Speed Shop. That's it. Don't need to pump this one.
It's fuel injected.
I think my stupid ass.
I love you, you stupid ass.
I already broke a blade off in here. Look at that. It's twisted to the left.
Man, this weather got me acting up though. It's like chilly, but it's not chilly. It's like you should have the heater on, but you shouldn't have the heater on. Where would one move where the weather's like good, but not like too hot? But winter isn't 6 months long. Let me know down below, cause I like, where do people move?
Safety, protect.
Good luck, Kyle.
My face shield's falling off. No, I bent my blade.
That puckered out.
My poor blade.
Oh yeah, it's smoking.
I hate exhaust hangers too.
Water displacement 40.
We got one piece of. This one's out with a bolt, what the heck? Oh, the factory hanger broke. Hey.
We call the big one daddy.
What the heck is this thing? Is this like some extra suspension thing here? Because we have a coil spring, but it looks like this is like some torsion bar underneath that. Is that a bottom out bar? I don't know. That's weird. Oh boy, let's try and struggle bust this tank out of here now. Probably haven't been down since whatever year this car is, 86. Holy bejeebers, that's tight. Our homemade cheater bar, you just put an extension and a socket on the end of a ratchet.
Then hopefully you break the gears and the ratchet, because that's bound to what be happening right now. Jeez, Louise. Also, I don't know who Louise is or what he did, but geez, that guy. Friendly game of, is it gonna snap off if we put an impact on it? My favorite game, actually. Mmm, dust taste. Old. There it goes. Big deal. I don't have a scoop, but I bet you this Ford cover thing works really good. Oh yeah.
Just making room for all good stuff to happen.
What a shame. There's like a speaker over here, none over here. Someone must have took it. Someone was like, hey, you can't have sound. Oh my God. What is this? I think we've got some wiring to do here, but I need to get, and this is cracked. Oh, that's sad. We actually need to get to the shock mount bolts to get the shocks to drop down from here. So we can start taking out the suspension over here. As you can see, the shocks kind of just hold it up. Springs fall out. And then it's the lower and upper control arms, and then this should just drop out. And for some reason, I bet you it's conveniently underneath this little panel right here. I think someone's been in here before because they cut this piece out, which is like insulation, but yeah, that's where a shock mount bolt is, so both of these have to come out.
Somebody pull this sneaky sneak in there.
Pew pew gun. Pew pew! I'm surprised that came off. I thought for sure the strut was gonna start spinning.
And with the power of editing, we were able to edit out every swear word that I used in that last video clip. Which means I cannot use any of that last video clip. But all the bolts are out now. So now we just have to lower down the suspension.
Oh my God, guys, oh my Lord. Okay, now I'll just cut those handbrake cables. We should be good. That's not gonna do it, we need a grinder. Here it comes, boys. Wait, the drive shaft's with it. I forgot about that. Honestly, that looks like a new drive shaft. Or U-joint, at least. You know what? That kind of looks like a brand new drive shaft. Anyways, under the car to be looking really clean. I still have to pull these off, and this was an exhaust hanger, so that's gotta go. Like, none of these torque boxes are showing any signs of rust on them, which is great. Upper ones are great. So now I'm kind of debating if we want to put our aftermarket torque boxes in this thing, which I kind of wanted to do just to learn how to do it, but I mean, do we do it or not? Like, I have a set of Team Z upper and lower torque boxes, which gives you like all the adjustability. But do we do that, or do we just, like, because these torque boxes are pretty weak, I don't want to rip them out of the frame either. I don't know, let me know down below if we should put those torque boxes in or not. I'm glad we got this cleaned out though, because now we can get the other 8.8 rear end over here and at least start getting it up to be a roller. Let's just spin this to see. Wait a minute. These are both rolling the same way. These things, like when you roll the drive shaft, they're both rolling the same way. Usually with like a open diff. they would roll the other way. What the shit?
Oh yeah, of course. The box with the torque boxes are actually like in the back corner over here. In order to get them, I have to take all this out, which means I have to move all this. Like once we have two race cars on the go, look at all the stuff in the middle of everywhere trying to get, it's so horrible.
I need some more space. One day, man, one day eventually, we just keep grinding, we keep going. And yeah, let me know what you guys think. Should we put the new torque boxes in this thing? It's gonna probably take me like a day, maybe, to cut out the old ones, get the new ones situated and maybe weld it in there. Like a whole day's work, probably 12 hours.
What I should do is I should knock out all this dirt in the fender well, let it fall on the floor because it's all dried and crusty, and clean up everything I can underneath here, clean up the floor so it's nice to work on again.
Also, since last update, Nick and I call each other like all the time, and it's like, I hate talking on the phone, but me and Nick talk on the phone for like hours at a time. He must be like my new boyfriend. Anyways, he said to just keep the regular old turbo kit because it's just a simple bolt-on thing, the T6 back housing. The only difference is we're gonna build a 5-inch exhaust instead of a 4-inch exhaust, but he's sending me more photos of turbos as they're being built. It's so exciting just to be like daily updates with turbos. Nick's like, hey, look at this new 79mm I built. And these turbos, they have bigger exhaust wheels in them. They're not like 79, 75s, which I really don't like the 78, 75 on a V8. I find the back housing is just too small in it. Like it'll light fast, but I don't know. I'm more geared towards a bigger back housing, not restricting the motor. So I prefer something like a 79-82 in a T4 or a 79-96 in a T6. That's just my preference because I like to go bigger, a little bit laggier, and then you keep the rods in the engine and you can rev it out a little harder. It's just me being a stock motor guy. That's the way I go. I always oversize my turbos instead of maximizing like the mid-range torquey stuff. Anyways, I've got some cleaning to do. I have to do a dump run for sure. This has to go to the dump. That has to go to the dump. All the pans and stuff in the back have to go to the dump. I have to take this stuff over to the other garage and get some bins to store it in. And we just have to make this better again because this is, I can't walk in here. All right, welcome to the After Boosted Lifestyle Show with me and Sullivan. This is Sullivan. You can call him Silly though. We're gonna start off with the weather. How's the weather today, Sullivan?
Good.
You heard it here first. It's good. So if you're in my area, it's probably good. Black Sheep Industries, we're restocking the 45s and 60mm wastegates sometime this month. The 45s are almost sold out of the current stock. So if you haven't got one, make sure to get one of yours before it goes out of stock again. And I don't know how much you guys like hearing about the behind the scenes stuff. I know you like hearing it because you like money. But we did Black Sheep, which is like super awesome because like to see this little thing that we had grow into something bigger. It's pretty awesome, and I'll keep you guys updated if you guys like hearing about it, and if you don't, then too bad, because I love talking about it.
By the way, my shirt almost matches that chair.
It does almost match that chair, except your shirt's blue and that's purple. I'm gonna call you a chair from now on.
No.
And then, True North Turbos, a partner company of Black Sheep Industries, just finished my own personal 88mm turbo. You can see it spin.
I'm pretending I put like a thing on the screen, so we're just gonna cut away to the thing on the screen. And it's gonna go wee.
What did you just say?
I said
shovel away. And also in this photo right here, you can see our 76s and 79mm being built. Super exciting. In other news, I checked the P.O. box, which I haven't checked in a while, and Dan at DD Speed Shop got mad at me, but he sent us a grinder. And it's like pretty cool, but he said he was gonna send me the app, like a friend request on the app, and then he didn't. But he didn't even send it to me. Instead he sent us a real grinder, which is, I mean, equally as cool, but not as cool as what it could have been. But what have you done lately?
Watch TV.
You watch TV. Didn't you build your own map in Roblox?
Oh yeah!
Our little genius over here, 7 years old, built his own map in Roblox. You have to like go.
I worked over an hour.
Yeah, and you have to like run away from a pig and collect like a key and open a door and use
and
a hammer.
Need it, yeah, there's a white key and a hammer door. Or you could just put the white key door.
And you gotta run away from a pig.
Uh-huh.
Little genius over here. The biggest news, you wanna hear this one? We're gonna get a new built engine.
What?
Yeah. So instead of making 1,000 horsepower, we're gonna make 1,300 horsepower.
And actually, our engine builder sent us a couple pictures. Here's a picture of the heads being assembled.
Pretend that I put a picture of the head on the screen here, and then you're gonna be like, ooh, that's so nice, Kyle.
Ooh, that's so nice, Kyle.
Yeah, it is. Anyways, this is like the most budget built motor you can get. It's like a piston rod combo with a stock crank and a stock block. And then we did buy cheap China heads just to like, because they're kind of nice and thicker deck on. It's going to make 1,300 horsepower, especially attached to that new True North Turbo's 88 millimeter.
Hey, what the heck were you doing?
He's over there meowing at us. Should we go flatten him?
Yeah.
We'll go flatten you. We'll flatten you. Try that again. See what happens.
He just looks.
Little butt. Anyways, that's our post Boosted Lifestyle video update thing, majigger. I'm Kyle. That's Sully. We're signing out. Peace, easy.
Peace.
And get that W for win. Get that win.